Tag TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.
Good evening. Welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Yeshi Johnson. Here are the top stories we are tracking for you on Wednesday, the 14th of July. Afghanistan's security situation dominates SCO meeting in Dushanbe. Pakistan bus blast kills 13, including 9 Chinese nationals. And new Nepal cabinet decides to vaccinate all citizens against COVID-19 by March next year. And now for all the details. Three terrorists, including a Pakistani commander of Lashkar-e-Taiba terror group, were neutralized in an encounter in Pulwama district of India's Jammu and Kashmir on Wednesday. India has long accused that Pakistan aids terrorists infiltrate across the border to spread unrest in Kashmir Valley. Pakistan, however, denies the allegations.
Three terrorists, including a top commander of Pakistan-based Lashkar-e-Taiba terror group, were neutralized by security forces in an encounter in Pulwama district of India's Union Territory of Jammu and Kashmir on Wednesday. Based on specific inputs, a cordon and search operation was launched during which the terrorists threw a grenade and fired upon the security personnel, after which a gunfight ensued, leading to the death of the three terrorists, including Ejaz Elias Abu Huraira, a Pakistani LET commander, police said.
Cordon karne ke baad militant ne andar se grenade throw kiya, phir firing kiya, hum retaliate kiye. क्योंकि सिविलियन बीच में फंसे हुए थे इसलिए हम ऑपरेशन को रोक दिए सिविलियन को पहले इवैक्यूएट किए वहां से फिर आज अर्ली मॉर्निंग में इनकाउंटर रिज्यूम हुआ जिसमें तीन टेररिस्ट मारे गए
इंडिया हैज लॉन्ग एक्यूज्ड दैट नेबरिंग पाकिस्तान एड्स एंड इन्फिल्ट्रेट्स टेररिस्ट्स अक्रॉस द बॉर्डर टू स्प्रेड अनरेस्ट इन कश्मीर वैली पाकिस्तान हाउएवर डिनाइज द चार्जेस
India's Foreign Minister S. Jaishankar on Wednesday said that combating terrorism and extremism is the key purpose of SCO, the Shanghai Cooperation Organization, and it must stop terror financing. He made the remarks at a key meeting of the grouping in Tajikistan to discuss the security situation in Afghanistan that was attended by his counterparts from Russia, Pakistan, and China. Jaishankar described the situation in Afghanistan as well as public health and economic recovery as pressing issues facing the region. He later wrote on Twitter, "Peace negotiations in earnest is the only answer. The world is against seizure of power by violence and force. It will not legitimize such actions," he said. Afghanistan has been witnessing the insurgent Taliban's violent campaign to capture major territories in the last few weeks as the US looks to complete its troop withdrawal by August 10. The volatile situation in Afghanistan has triggered global concerns. In news from Pakistan, 9 Chinese workers were among 13 people killed when a blast on a bus sent it careering down a ravine in northwestern Pakistan on Wednesday. It was not immediately clear whether the blast was the result of a roadside device or something planted inside the bus. Beijing has asked Pakistan to investigate the incident. At least 13 people, including 9 Chinese nationals and 2 Pakistani soldiers, were killed after a blast sent a bus plunging into a ravine in a remote region of North Pakistan on Wednesday, media reports suggest. It was not immediately clear whether the blast was the result of a roadside device or something planted inside the bus. The dead and injured, including the Chinese engineers, were brought to the regional health center in Dasu, about 10 kilometers from the site of the blast.
और अभी तक इसकी तहकीकात जारी है कि इसकी असल वजह क्या थी पुलिस वहां पे मौके पे मौजूद है और बम डिस्पोजेबल स्क्वाड वाले भी वहां पे मौजूद हैं तो जैसे ही उनकी इन्वेस्टिगेशन की रिपोर्ट सामने आएगी तो हम इस पोजीशन में होंगे कि आपको जो फैक्चुअल पोजीशन है उससे आपको
Meanwhile, China on Wednesday asked Pakistan to thoroughly investigate the incident. Beijing condemned the blast, expressed condolences and asked Pakistan to protect the safety of Chinese personnel, institutions and projects. Foreign Ministry spokesman Xiao Lijian told a regular news briefing. The Dasu Hydroelectric Project is part of the China-Pakistan Economic Corridor, CPEC, a $65 billion investment plan under Beijing's Belt and Road Initiative that is aimed at connecting western China to the Gwadar seaport in southern Pakistan. Moving on, the Chief Election Commissioner of Pakistan-administered Kashmir has ordered a fresh inquiry against Pakistani Minister Ali Amin Gandapur for donating cash during election campaigning in the illegally occupied region. Locals and political activists have blamed all major political parties are engaged in pre-poll rigging ahead of assembly election on July 25.
Chief Election Commissioner of Pakistan-administered Kashmir has ordered a fresh inquiry against Pakistani Minister Ali Amin Gandapur for donating cash ahead of the July 25 election in the illegally occupied region. A video of the minister donating cash during the campaign for his Pakistan Tehreek-e-Insaf party went viral last week, prompting the CEC to take notice of the matter. A PTI member also admitted to receiving money from Gandapur, after which the returning officer from Mirpur seized the cash. Meanwhile, a local politician from PMLN, Pakistan Muslim League Nawaz, has levelled serious charges on political parties ruling the illegally occupied region for years, including his own. He blamed successive governments have been functioning on a rotation system, where each party gets equal opportunity to loot the exchequer and fill its own coffers.
हम ये जरूर चाहते हैं कि ये जो है ना ये छोटा सा खिता है ठीक है ना हां 22 25 या 26 लाख जो है ना या 30 लाख होगा ज्यादा से ज्यादा आबादी होगी लेकिन यकीन जाने कि वो 30 लाख जो है ना उसका सारा बजट जो है ना ये 48 का टोला आपस में मिक्सिंग करके एक किस्म की अय्याशी कर रहा है वो हड्डी मुंह में दे देते हैं और ये बजाय इसके कि عوام पे लगाने के ये जो है ना आपस में बंदर बांध करके एक 5 साल दूसरा 5 साल तीसरा
Locals blame that years of continued neglect by Islamabad and a corrupt administrative system has made Pakistan-administered Kashmir one of the most backward regions in South Asia.
In the first meeting of the newly formed cabinet of Prime Minister Sher Bahadur Deoba, it has been decided to administer vaccines against COVID-19 to all eligible citizens across the country by March next year. Deoba faces the immediate task of procuring COVID-19 vaccines and control the spread of the coronavirus that has infected more than 658,000 people in the Himalayan nation.
Nepal's newly appointed Prime Minister Sher Bahadur Deoba on Tuesday evening took oath of office and secrecy amidst a special function held at the office of the President. Nepali President Bidya Devi Bhandari also administered oath of office and secrecy to four ministers of the Deoba-led cabinet. Soon after assuming new roles, Deoba-led cabinet decided to administer vaccines against COVID-19 to all eligible citizens across the country by March next year. The first meeting of the newly formed cabinet held late evening on Tuesday made a decision to this effect. Deoba, who has held the office four times before, faces the immediate task of procuring COVID-19 vaccines and control the spread of the coronavirus that has infected more than 658,000 people and killed nearly 10,000. Figures experts say fail to reflect the true toll. More than 1.3 million people have had a first dose of COVID-19 vaccine and are awaiting a second dose as the government scrambles to protect its people. 75-year-old Deoba, head of the centrist Nepali Congress Party, will head a coalition with former Maoist rebels and a party representing a minority community dominant on Nepal's southern plains. Party officials said the leader was expected to name his full cabinet after the vote of confidence he must win in parliament in the next month.
In news from Afghanistan, the UN Refugee Agency has warned over the looming humanitarian crisis in Afghanistan due to ongoing violence in the country. An estimated 270,000 Afghans have been newly displaced inside the country since January 2021, primarily due to insecurity and violence, bringing the total uprooted population to over 3.5 million.
More Afghans are likely to flee their homes due to escalating violence, UNHCR, the UN Refugee Agency, warned on Tuesday, as the Taliban take control of more territory in response to the withdrawal of US-led foreign forces. Babar Baloch, a spokesman of the UNHCR, told a Geneva news briefing an estimated 270,000 Afghans had been newly displaced inside the country since January, bringing the total population forced from their homes to more than 3.5 million. He emphasized that a failure to reach a peace agreement in Afghanistan and stem the current violence will lead to further displacement within the country.
Afghanistan is on the brink of another humanitarian crisis. This can be avoided. This should be avoided. So efforts to secure peace has to be strengthened and doubled. And this is what Afghans expect.
Meanwhile, former Afghan President Hamid Karzai said on Tuesday that serious peace talks will begin soon in the country and urged the government not to waste opportunities for peace. He did not specify details about the talks. Peace talks between the Taliban and the government have nominally been continuing in Qatar's capital, but officials say they are making little progress.
Inshallah ta'ala. شما بسیار بزودی آغاز دوباره مذاکرات بسیار جدی صلح را شاهد می باشید. حوصله کنین، تدبیر کنین و به طرف صلح برید.
Violence has surged in the country since US President Joe Biden announced in April that American troops would withdraw by September 11, ending 20 years in Afghanistan. The Taliban have made a fresh push to surround cities and gain territory, emboldened by the departure of foreign forces.
Horsemen in India's northern hill station of Kufri are now back in business after tourist footfall has increased amid the pandemic. Tourists from across the country are visiting hill stations in the north to escape the scorching heat as lockdown restrictions have also eased. Horsemen in hill station of Kufri in India's northern Himachal Pradesh state are on the track to recovery as they have restarted their work with the arrival of tourists in spite of the coronavirus pandemic. Tourists from across the country are visiting hill stations in the north to escape the scorching heat after the lockdown restrictions were eased. This has helped people integrated with the tourism industry earn a living after bearing heavy losses during the second wave of the pandemic. On Tuesday, tourists were seen enjoying horse rides, enabling the horsemen to get a decent earning after being out of work for months.
से दो साल हो गए प्रॉपर कोरोना काल में जैसे हमारी रोजी रोटी पे बहुत ज्यादा असर पड़ा है जिस कारण ना यहां पर अपने लिए घोड़ों के लिए इनको चला पाना बहुत ही मुश्किल है और जो हमारे लड़के रहते हैं उनकी तनख्वाह निकालना भी बहुत मुश्किल रहता है सर यहां पर दो साल से जो हमारे ऊपर अभी थोड़ा सा सीजन चला है यहां पर थोड़ा सा 10-15 दिनों से थोड़ा सा लग रहा है कि हल्का सा क्राउड बढ़ा है यहां पे ना जिस कारण लग रहा है थोड़ा सा ऐसे ही कि बाकी तो यहां पर कोरोना का ऐसा है कि सर बगैर मास्क के हम किसी लोगों को जाने दे रहे
मुंबई में हम बहुत ही परेशान हो गए थे क्लाइमेट से भी तो यहां पे हम शिमला में बहुत एंजॉय कर रहे हैं बहुत ही अच्छा लग रहा है और हमारी एनिवर्सरी भी है तो वो हिसाब से हम यहां घूमने के लिए आए हैं
India on Wednesday reported 38,792 new COVID-19 cases in the last 24 hours, taking the cases tally to 30.94 million, with 411,408 deaths so far. Well, that's all we have for you from South Asia this evening. Now, our viewers can watch the show on southasianewsline.com. You can also visit us on facebook.com/asianewsline and follow us on Twitter at asianewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We will see you same time tomorrow. Good night.
Subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.